Lawrence Haverty, he did like the IPO for Alexander Graham Bell or whatever in Boston a million years ago with Gamco. Larry, good noon to you. Great to have you on the show.
Hi, Tom.
LinkedIn, you and I were talking about it before we went on air. Why should people sell now when the lock before the lockup is up?
Well, I think Milton Friedman covered it. There's no such thing as a shortage. There's only a shortage at a price. And Wall Street creates a temporary shortage by issuing 8 million shares. Let's say $350 million is raised. The stock triples. That goes up to $1 billion. Sitting behind the stock, Tom, is 18 million options, which become unlocked probably in a little less than 6 months. And the supply is going to increase from 7 million to probably 25, 30 million very, very quickly. And as the supply increases, Act 101 says the price is going to go down. So the only question for the investor, and I don't think there's any investors in here, there's only games players. The only question for the investor is how soon they should sell before the lockup period is announced. And I don't have the answer for that. This is not something that we even consider investing in at Gamco.
Yeah,
this is a sideshow. It's a magic show.
You look at, bring up this intraday chart here, if you would. Sorry, Victor, to mess you up there with the camera. Haverty suggests sell now, and you see the sideshow, as he describes it, of LinkedIn. Why is this time different than 1999, Lawrence Haverty? Is there a different character to this budding frenzy in the internet?
Well, these are real. LinkedIn's a real company. It has revenue. It has profit. And we can size, Tom, what the opportunity is. And let me just give you an example of what happened in the last quarter. Google, which is a pretty good company and sells it, I think, somewhere around 10 times cash flow, converted 15% of its incremental revenue to cash flow in the last quarter. I used to think a good internet company could, once they hit break even, which is where LinkedIn is, could convert 70%. I think now wage costs are so high in Silicon Valley. Google gave everyone wage raises.
Right.
The tax receipts in California are way ahead of plan. That probably you have maybe the ability to convert, if you're a company like LinkedIn, 40%. So they make no money this year. Take the revenue up. Stock's probably worth $30, $35 at most.
This is so critical, folks. I'm going to do something I rarely do. Mr. Haverty, I want you to repeat this. They do an incremental dollar of cash flow, and you want to see 70% of that go to where? The net income line?
To EBITDA. But Google in the last quarter only did 15%. Now, I think Google's got some cost management problems.
Right.
But I think because wages are going up in Silicon Valley, and we know that California tax receipts are way higher than people have thought, we know that there's going to be a cost problem for these companies. So you get your incremental profit number. It really can't be any more than 40%, Tom, in this environment. And that gives you, you know, somewhere $30, $35, $40 stock.
Elegant chart, and then I want to get to media here. This is the SQL, Internet Frenzy 2. This is great. We normalize back to 1998, Amazon, eBay, and Microsoft. And it's remarkable how Amazon and eBay have ended up at the same point, normal, back to 1998. And yet their glide path is so different. What's going to be the Facebook glide path? Larry Haverty, are they going to explode out of the gates and go level like eBay, or are they going to build?
There's no way of knowing. It's just a game between the managements, the boards, and Wall Street about how many shares they release of these companies. The more shares they release, Tom, the lower the price will be. And obviously, the bankers guessed wrong. And from the point of view of raising capital for the company, they didn't raise enough capital in the LinkedIn thing. So they get another swing at the plate, and maybe they hit the ball better. Nobody knows. And the reality is, I don't think as an investor in these industries, you should particularly care.
Okay, but critically, and it was over the social media space this weekend, Zero Hedge and that crew, I can't remember the exact sequence of storylines. Who is to blame here for this misvaluation? Is it the bankers in New York, or is it the Silicon Valley crew?
Well, I think it's clearly the bankers underestimated demand, but you get these feeding frenzies, and Interest rates are very low. I mean, you've had endless dialogue about the effect of QE3 and 2, and there's a lot of dollars wandering around, and goodness gracious, some of them found their way to the broker and bought LinkedIn stock. And maybe the Fed takes away part of the punch bowl June 30th, and there are less dollars when Facebook and Zynga and Twitter consider going public. Nobody knows, but I think if I were those companies, the window clearly is open now, and I think you have to accelerate the process of going public. And I think this is great, Tom, because I think it's going to really help reduce the deficit. I calculate that the financial gains on LinkedIn could easily result in $1 billion of incremental tax revenue to California and New York, both of which sorely need it. And if you recall, listening to Governor Dean enough, Clinton cured the deficit problem in the 90s. The reason he did it was because you had this internet boom.
Right.
So a little internet boom is really, really good for the fiscal authorities. And at the end of the day, somebody's going to lose a lot of money. But meanwhile, I think this is going to continue. Now, as an investor, I really have no business in this playing field. This is not investment, Tom. This is speculation.
Right. Larry, 1 minute's all I got left. Earth to Comcast shareholder return. Let's switch back to the core Larry Haverty view here, which is media. What's your scorecard on Comcast so far, and are they going to give a shareholder return? We're back there, folks, a decade, and they've underperformed the S&P 500.
Well, I think if you knock that stock down, Tom, I think they had a religious moment a few years ago when they started to pay a dividend. They had been buying back stock. We had a company in Canada, Rogers Communication.
Yes.
We've now made 6 times in the stock. They had the same religious moment about 6 years ago, and I think they're on the path right now to wonderful financial stability and financial management of the stock and the business. The stock is very undervalued, in my opinion. I'm very optimistic that Steve Burke, who is I think one of the best managers I've ever met, is going to work wonders at Universal. It's a good asset.
Great.
They financed it at a good cost. They didn't pay too much money, and I think the stars are aligning in South Philadelphia right now over the Comcast Center.
Larry, thank you so much. Just brilliant on LinkedIn. Of course, his opinion, one opinion among many.